Good day and welcome to our webinar about the International Master's Program in Comparative Social Research. Thank you for tuning in. I hope everything is fine and you hear me well and you see me well. The coming 30 minutes, I guess, I have the opportunity here to introduce you to our master's program. I will talk a little bit about the approach, our ideas about the program, the content, of course, and about our graduates or our lecturers and everything about the program, I guess. And in the end, you will have the opportunity to also pose your own questions, yeah, and I will answer them here. All right, comparative social research. Although this master's program is based at the School for Sociology at the Higher School of Economics, you've already see the name is broader, right? Referring to a broader discipline, to social research and even to some kind of comparison. And I'd like to use here the first part of my presentation to introduce to you to our ideas. What is this program about? And maybe me as a person, I'm a good impersonation of the program. I am a sociologist myself, and I'm not Russian. I'm from Germany. I studied and did my PhD at the University of Leipzig in Germany, one of the oldest universities in Europe. But then I worked after that, or always in different countries. So I'm my self-identity is somehow kind of related to a global approach of the national approach of sociology. I worked in Sweden for many years, and since 2015, I'm here heading this master's program in comparative social research. This is an English language program, so it means everything, lecturing, and also all administrative aspects are done in English. And we have a lot of international lecturers in the program, a lot of international students. And I will talk first a bit about the program itself, because the approach of our program is also an international global approach. Not just in terms of our spatial focus. We are not focused on any region or country in the world, but we are interested in researching societies all over the globe, and maybe even global society. But our approach is also global in terms of methodology. And I don't know if you have prior knowledge in sociology, but you have heard of those two gentlemen here on the next slide. Emil Durkheim, one of the founding fathers of sociology. For him, comparative sociology was already the core of his discipline. He helped founding. For him, sociology comparison is one of the core methods of contemporary sociology, because only comparison in his view gives the opportunity to actually kind of explain social facts, phenomena, not just describe them. This was developed, of course, in many, many different directions by many theorists, but also empirical sociologists. And one of the best known in the world, I would say, our current world, is Roland Engelhardt. Yeah, he's maybe not the sociologist himself. He's just recently became, I guess, the most cited political scientist in the world. But he is one of the driving and still is driving forces of comparative social research. Yeah, beginning with founding the World Value Survey. You have heard of this global survey study. About attitudes and values in the world, throughout the world, and in many, many different countries. But his idea was also, and his theoretical foundation was always kind of, we need a comparison in order to kind of see how societies evolve and develop. Only when we compare societies to each other, we come close to some kind of an objective knowledge how a modern society actually develop, and only when we know this, we can actually judge how well social policies work, how well reform programs work, and what we could imagine for improving contemporary society. So this is actually what is our, you know, what is our approach about in the program. It's not about a specific topic. It's not about a specific method, but it's about giving our students the ability to use a lot of methods applying to a lot of topics, but in a comparative matter, in order to actually reach some kind of an objectifiable knowledge about our modern societies, yeah, in order to get this applied to real world problems. Yeah. And just to give you a little here, yeah, this is just about to say what is comparison about, not just comparing cultures, of course, or societies. This is maybe the macro level of comparison. But we see comparison also applied to social groups, political, religious, ethnical groups, gender. Yeah, so on up to a very micro level of maybe neighbors in different districts, yeah, you can apply comparison to all kinds of social phenomena in our current societies. And here are some examples of student works. That is a topics of master thesis, and here you see how this what we given our program can be applied to very different topics. Yeah, you see the first two topics are about gender. Yeah, gender is one of the popular topics in our program. And here you see the first topic, international comparison of gender differences on the labor market. This is an international comparative study using quantitative data, yeah, statistics to study gender differences on the labor market. And the second topic here is also about gender difference on the labor market, but coming from a qualitative approach, yeah, employing here interviews in two different countries, Germany and Russia, in order to see how women build their career paths and give meaning to certain things they do while building those careers in science. So two very good, excellent master thesis, yeah, about gender, but coming from different methodological approaches. This is possible in our program. The same with the next two examples. The second example here in the middle is about higher education and students and universities. Also one of the popular topics in our program, yeah, so self-reflection, yeah, about us as students and we at universities. And the first study also employing here a quantitative research design, looking at how students relate to violations of academic dishonesty and what they think should be done about this. Yeah, and here a student compared regions in Russia, yeah, to each other. And in the second, here the second case is about what kind of meaning students in Russia and England give to their own studies. What does it mean to study at a university? Yeah, and there was also an interview study in two different country contexts. Yeah, comparing how people relate to studying and what does it mean for them then to be dishonest. Yeah, and here you text reveals a lot of study reveals a lot of differences. Yeah, so also two excellent works. And this, the third example about migration and inter-ethnic relationships, also a very popular topic in our master program. The first work here about also quantitative research design was also a survey among students in one university in Russia, and how students from different ethnic backgrounds relate to each other. Yeah, about this was about prejudices and what Russians think about the Jews and Jews think about other ethnic groups and so on. Yeah, this was also a very interesting comparative study using statistics. And the second one is about Lebanese migrants in Moscow. And here the comparison was with those Lebanese who are still in Libya and planning to come. So what is the difference here in their identity, yeah, before and after the migration? Also a very good qualitative study. So this is just to give an example or some kind of impression what students are doing, yeah, in compared to social research in our program. Here are some general facts about our program. This is a usual 2 years master's program with 120 credits, as in most European countries. We have we are quite relatively small master's program. We have 15 places paid by the Russian government for Russian students, and five actually this year six scholarship places for foreign students. This intake is already completed. We have unfortunately no 100% scholarship places for foreign students anymore available, but we have still commercial slots. So it means fee-paying. Students can still apply and have a chance to get into the program. And what is a great new feature in our program since this year, so this is the first year we actually did this from start to the end, we have two double degree tracks, and I will talk about this in a couple of minutes. We have two double degree tracks, with one with Paris and one with Berlin, where students in our program have the chance to earn a second degree from one of those two partner universities. And one of the features in our program is a strong focus on academic research. That's why our students are required to do a research internship in the third semester. I'll talk about this also in a couple of minutes. They can do this in Russia or abroad, and we will in a very individual supervision put this up, for each student. Our students are involved in research projects, mostly international research projects at HSE, from the very beginning, from the first semester. Students get in contact with our lecturers and get involved in their research projects. So you will, students in our program, they collect research experience from the very beginning throughout the whole program. Instruction is fully in English, not just the teaching is done in English, but also all administrative matters are done in English. And at HSE, you have a lot of services and a lot of institutional support for international students. So this is the, for international students, is the best place to go in Russia, I would say. What is also a feature of our program, and we are very caring about this, that every year we have a lot of guest researchers at the School for Sociology and at other institutions, who we then invite to give guest lectures and workshops exclusively for our program's students. So we have a lot of input and contact opportunity with international scholars outside the usual curriculum. Because I see here that the science sociology at HSE is actually highly ranked in the world. Yeah, so in already the third year in a row, we are top 100 in the QS rating, and Times Higher Education rating also ranks sociology at HSE quite high. We are not yet in the top 100, but top 120 or top 130. So, but every year we rise 50 places. So, this is great and exciting for us that lecturers at our university in sociology are world class. Yeah, you cannot say it differently. Here you see a little glimpse on our general program structure, and you see already the main difference vis-a-vis other master programs. The teaching, all the lectures and seminars you will have only in the first year. Yeah, you see here modules 1 and 2 and modules 3 and 4. This is for learning, in class. So we will have a quite full schedule in the first year. So we try to give you as much as possible input in order to prepare you for your own research. Yeah. You see here in the first semester, the first two modules are about like basic methods, but also about introduction into basic concepts of comparative sociology. But also you have the opportunity to select courses according to your thematic interests. So our program has one of the, I would say, largest collection and opportunities for choosing elective courses according to your interest, not just at the department or faculty level, but also outside. And the second semester, then module 3 and 4 are about advanced methods. You will see a list in a second. And the second study here is dedicated to your own research. So in the third semester, you do your research internship, at least 10 weeks, at some academic or non-academic institution, but it should be research related in Russia or abroad. You can just do this internship and then do a fieldwork for your master thesis or combine both of it. Or you also go abroad for one of our double degree tracks, or use one of quite many opportunities at HSE to participate in study exchange. Yeah? For example, the Erasmus Plus framework offers a lot of opportunities to apply for a scholarship place and or to go to a partner university. Many of our students do this actually. And then in this fourth module, you are free to concentrate on your master's thesis. Yeah? This is very important for us. This is the main event in our program, that you then sit down and write your master's thesis on an excellent level. And continuously throughout all both years, you will have the opportunity to participate in guest lectures, in workshops by our invited international scholars. They are staying at institutions, at research centers or laboratories at HSE, or we invite them ourselves, because the School of Sociology, me and colleagues, lecturers of the program, we organize an annual international seminar series in sociology, where we invite the national colleagues to present their current research. Here a little glimpse also at the study or the course courses for next not just for this year actually. So you see three columns, right? And these are the three main categories of our study plan and the program. And first, it's not by chance, are the methods. Yeah. So our program is about to give you the instruments into your hands to do your own research and to apply this to all kinds of topics. Yeah. This is then also important for your future employment, that you go onto the market and you are able to do whatever research project is necessary, yeah, is required of you. So we start here, of course, with basic statistics. For some of you, it will be a refreshment of what you have learned already in your bachelor's, but not all of our students come from sociology. Yeah? So social research is, of course, a broader field. So we have also political scientists, we have economists, we have cultural scientists, we have people from the humanities, historians, also linguists, yeah. So this is quite a broad field of disciplines in our classroom, which makes, of course, group discussions extremely interesting. Yeah, but we, of course, we need to get everybody on the same page when it comes to statistics. And what is also great in our program is you will learn the analytical statistical instrument of R. Yeah, it's a programming related language for and of building your own analytical instruments to do statistical analysis. We have wonderful courses and unique courses on multi-level regression analysis and structural equation modeling. Those are indeed unique in our program, especially the structural equation modeling, but also multi-level regression analysis. These are you won't get in any other place, probably in Russia on the master's level. What we also offer is an introduction into approaches and actually usage of big data analysis. We have a wonderful course, very popular course on social network analysis, also on qualitative comparative analysis, which is a method combining quantitative and qualitative approaches to analysis. We are not just totally fixed on quantitative methods. We also offer courses in ethnographic methods and more qualitative approaches of social research. So that students indeed can choose their topics freely because they have all the necessary instruments in their hand. The middle column here, the theoretical part, is very flexible. Yeah, you will have a compulsory course on comparative sociology. I'm teaching that just to kind of introduce you into the concepts of comparative sociology, how to think about this, how to conceptualize also your your research questions, yeah. But then all the other courses you see here are elective. Yeah, you can choose, and etc. At the end is not also not by chance. We have of course courses we recommend, but you can choose freely among the English language courses at HSE to satisfy your needs and your interests. Yeah, so you can also take courses from other faculties. So here, this is very, we have a very individual approach to every student's research interests and plans. And the third column, research preparation, is very important for us as well. We'll have a research seminar in every module, where we discuss and try to develop, yeah, in the first year, your own research questions, your research projects. So at the end of the first study year, you will have a developed excellent research proposal already in your hands, and you will already know what you will do in the second year for a master thesis. We will develop this together, yeah, in class discussions and individual discussions, the whole project. And then, of course, the internship is very important for us to actually get you into the field and do academic research. And the guest lectures and workshops, they give you the opportunity, of course, to see how others do this in the world, and you can pose questions, and you can, get insights, yeah, and informal knowledge about how to do research, how to plan research, how to publish, and so on. Yeah, although we would also discuss the publishing process, for example, in the research seminar. Also, you will have to write a peer review about an article as well, and we will discuss the whole process, how to get published, and so on. This is also very important here, for example. This is in the part of academic presentation. Yeah. So at the end of our 2 years, you will be already a social researcher, yeah, from A to Z, starting from the methods over the what to do with theory, how to write a text, integrating theory and your empirical results. You will know how to build a whole project, yeah, from A to B, with all what it is you need to include, not just the field work, but also all the things and many things around this. Yeah? So we are more than ready to share our insights of academic research on all the steps of the way. About the internship, this is very important for us. And you see here a little selection of places where our students usually go. Many of our students stay at HSE because HSE is so rich of institutes, laboratories, centers where you can do all kinds of research. And HSE is, of course, always eager to get students involved in projects. But our students also go abroad. Yeah, you see here Tilburg University, one of our main partners for internship. Yeah, always offers a couple of places to our students to get involved into their own research projects. They are the headquarters of the European Value Study, so they have always the latest data and a lot of projects going on. But also our students, they go to the University of Helsinki, yeah, the Alexanteri Institute, where one of our students, for example, last year was involved in a couple of projects. Yeah. But also the Center for East European International Studies in Berlin, we have a cooperation with them that they are eager to get our students involved in their projects and so on. Yeah. But not just academic institutions are good places for internships for our students, but also international non-governmental organizations. Yeah. For example, the OECD in Paris, or the UN, yeah, other academic or institutions where research is needed and is done, yeah, but for already policy development purposes, yeah. Our students are very well placed because of their methodological knowledge. Yeah. Yes, you do this in the third semester, and you are basically free to do it wherever you like, and we often sit down with our students and make an individual plan. So what are the research project and interests, and then we look for where to place our student abroad in Russia, what are the best professors to go to, the best center to go to, how is that, can it be combined with the double degree track or then study abroad exchange program, and so on. Yeah, so this is a very individual kind of model here, our internship. Now a couple of words about our double degree tracks. Yeah, we have a cooperation agreement with the Freie University in Berlin and the School for Advanced Studies in Social Science in Paris. And in Berlin, we cooperate here with the Institute for East European Studies, the head of it, which is Professor Katharina Blum. And this is they have the same structure, master of their master program, so the integration is here very obvious and easily done. And here you see a couple of topics you will have to study. So of course, participating in a double degree comes with an additional study load, of course, but you earn a second degree. But in the end, you write one master thesis, which is then defended or is submitted at both universities. Yeah, that means, but that means also that you will write your master thesis in English, but with two supervisors, with one of from the public university and one from HEC. Yeah? And the same goes for Paris. Here we cooperate with also in a research institute for post-Soviet space, Russia and the Caucasus, the head of which is Françoise Dossier, here a very well-known scholar in that area. They have also a similar structure of the master program here in sociology. You will have to study as well, yeah, and collect credits here to get the to diploma, but also you write one master thesis in double, in co-supervision, yeah, with colleagues, the colleague from there and from HSE. And we, this is very popular. This year, four students go to Paris and six to Berlin. So this is, and from Berlin and Paris, students come to us. So in the first year, we will have contact with them as well. They were sitting with us and with you in the same seminar. So that makes our classroom very international, not just because of the double degree participants from Berlin and Paris, but we have also six international students enrolled in our program directly in Moscow. So you see, this is an indeed a global classroom here, plus international lecturers. So very, very unusual. But here I want to present also shortly here our main Russian partner, which is in laboratory, the National Laboratory for Social Comparative Social Research at HSE. And this is a unique and very famous institution, founded 2010 by Eduard Ponarin, which is the most left one here on the picture, and Ronald Engelhardt, yeah, the person I already talked about in the beginning. HSE was able to get him involved in HSE. He is still here, coming here once or twice a year. And that laboratory has over 50 different international projects studying values and attitudes throughout the world in international cooperation as well. They have huge events. Yeah, they have their annual conferences, international workshops, summer schools, and weekly seminars, and so. And our students are always welcome to participate. Yeah, so this is like we are very well attached to that laboratory. Here we have you have also the opportunity to engage in an vast international network in order to first to find someone to do your internship with, or to find an international supervisor, or if you want to go on afterwards for PhD, you have also kind of opportunity here to connect yourself to institutions and possible supervisors. So this is an international environment here open to our students all the time. Yeah? So this is just wonderful. Also, many students do their internship directly in the in this laboratory. They have a dependence here in Moscow and in St. Petersburg, so you can also do St. Petersburg for an internship, so there's also a wonderful opportunity. And here a little glimpse on our group of lecturers here at HSE. So these are the permanent lecturers in our program. You see, there's a quite young couple of fellows. Yeah. This is also like a feature of our classroom. Yeah, we have our lecturers are already accomplished, but still younger colleagues, not yet long years professors. That means we have already kind of our ideals, and we have always are striving for improving our classroom, our lecturing. We are very close to the students. They are all very open. Yeah, to talk to students and to involve students. So this is just exciting. Yeah, to see how well this works. Yeah, how dynamic the classroom is. They're coming from all over the world. That means they're coming with their own experience. How this is done in their home country, so you have a very very dynamic classroom, yeah, and very different experiences of lecturing and teaching and so on. Here are some of our most famous, I would say, guest lecturers. Yeah, here Hans-Peter Kriesian on the left and Christian Welzer on the right. These are highly acclaimed global scholars, if you want to look them up. So this is just wonderful. They come to HSE and do lectures and workshops just for our students. Yeah, so this is here you get really cutting edge knowledge and experience. From those worldwide renowned scholars. Yeah, they are coming because they're involved into the laboratory for comparative social research, you know, and it's a great opportunity for our students. Yeah, to get in contact with them. And Christian Welzer he's always excited about the program here, and he also feels that particular exciting atmosphere in our program. Yeah, especially because the faculty is internationally mobile and involved. They have all international projects themselves. You have a kind of a really global spirit in our program. And here's some examples of how our international students refer to our program. And here in both examples, there you see how well they appreciate the kind of combination between theoretical insights from our courses and the empirical and methodological practice offered by our program, that you indeed here can kind of accumulate this into your own successful research projects. But who are our graduates? Yeah, what do our students do after studying? And of course, most of our students, they go on staying in an academic sphere somehow. Yeah, some are successful and go abroad and enroll into a PhD program in a graduate school, as Kirill Smakarovsky did. Is now a student at the University of Essex and does his PhD. Others stay at HSE in laboratories or research centers and do their PhD. But some of us, they just stay at the place of their internship. Yeah, for example, Miguel did his internship in the UN commission in for Latin America and just got an offer there to stay as a consultant and just stay. So this is a good example also how our students are find their places outside the academia, but in a research-related environment. Here just an overview where our students work. So if they go, if they stay in academia and in Russia, they mostly stay at HSE because it's the best place for social researchers, of course, in Russia. Or they enroll into graduate schools abroad. For example, we have now this year they to Uppsala, or last year to Germany and Uppsala in Sweden, and we have also PhD students in England and in Germany. Or when students stay in in Russia, they often find themselves in market research, of course, as many sociologists, but also in consulting and think tanks. Yeah. And if they are able to enter the international job market, then often they start in non-governmental organizations as the UN. Who should apply? Who is the ideal student for us? Right? It is not necessary to have a sociological diploma. Yeah? If you have a relation to the broader social sciences, so like political science, anthropology, psychology as well, history and so on, economics, you are very well eligible to apply to our program. you have to take in, or be in mind that our program is focused on academic research. Yeah, so quite an academic oriented program. So you should have a strong interest in academic research. But research is research, and you can apply this also outside the academia, especially in all kinds of research institutions and environments outside the university, as think tanks, but also companies and international organizations. And of course, you should be open to an international classroom, to interact in English language with international students and international lecturers from all over the world. To apply to our program is quite easy and not much work, I would say. You need to provide everything online. So this is very easy, to just register an admission on the admissions site at the main page of HSE. And then you submit a CV, a table form, usual. And you also need to provide, and this is very important, the motivation letter and the research statement. But both letters have to be not too long, so a maximum one page, where you, if it's the second page is also okay, we will not stop reading, but you need to explain here why do you apply to our program, why is comparative social research important to you? What does it give you in your opinion for your future career and so on? Yeah, and in the research statement, you want to read about your previous research experience, what kind of methods you have used when you have studied what kind of topics. But also, we want to know about your future research plans and ideas. How do you want to apply comparison to your future research plans in the coming 2 years when you enter our program? We also need to have two recommendation letters in English, ideally. I know for that might be difficult for some colleagues in Russia. So if there's one letter also in Russian language, it's not a big problem, but it should be two recommendation letters from your previous teachers or people in an academic environment. Could also be from someone where you did an internship with, but it should be a review about your research-related abilities. Of course, your diploma or transcript of previous educational studies and an English certificate or some kind of evidence. It could be IELTS or the Cambridge test or whatever. About your English language abilities. If you do not have such, that means also if you do not have such from the last 2 years, not older, then it's also no. It gives you less points for the portfolio assessment, but still you have the opportunity to do a little interview with me at the beginning of August shortly after the. Admission deadline, and then we do a little interview, just to see how well you speak English and understand English, and then you still get a couple of points for your portfolio. You can earn it as well without English certificate, so you still can apply. And you see here apply, you can until July 31st. If you are from abroad as well, July 31st is the deadline, but if you please do not, since you have to submit online, if you are in Russia, you just can bring your portfolio on paper to the admission to the intake commission here, then you can do this under July 31st. But you have to register if you want to submit online, you have to register until July 29th, I guess, in order to kind of have enough time to set this account up and to upload your documents. So please do not do this on July 31st, but earlier, this opening up your application applicant's account. Of course, now would be the time to pose your own questions, and some of you have done this already. I thank you for your attention so far. If you have If you want to write me an email and post your questions as an email, please do that so. Yeah, I'm here. Here's my email address. You can also approach our program coordinator. Probably you know our website already, but we updated it and news are coming in all the time. So look there from time to time. We have also a Facebook page where you can follow us and our news. Otherwise, I just go on to our questions here. The first question I have already answered is an internship. Yes, of course. And this is very important for us. And yeah, I guess you have heard what I've said about this. The second question is, what are the estimated costs of living in Paris for a semester? Yeah, this is, of course, the double degree, both double degree tracks, they are free of study costs. So it means you do not have to pay for your education at the universities in Berlin and Paris, but you still have to cover your living costs and your transport and everything yourself, of course. Living costs, as you might imagine, are quite high in Paris. They are lower in Berlin, but still, accommodation is still a problem. But in Berlin and in Paris, we have the opportunity to place our students in university dormitories. But in Paris, this costs around 500 euros a month, and in Berlin, around 450 euros a month for a single room in a student dormitory community. Yeah, plus then just what you eat and what you need for public transport. Next question is, what should a student do to apply for a double degree program? The competition for one of the places for double degree happens just within our program. Yeah, so this is just only for our students. There are not places for all our students. That means there is some competition, but of course not everybody wants to go abroad. Yeah, so. So we did this now, this competition, two years, every applicant got a place. Yeah? We have five places for each university. In Berlin, we have more places available, it depends on how many students come from Berlin to Moscow. So the more students come from Berlin, the more students can go to Berlin from us, from our side. So, but at least five for each public university are available for us. But competition is only within our program. So the chances are quite good, very good indeed, actually, to get one of those places. The level of English, I mean, if you have understood me here now today, you're on a good way. You should be able to express yourself at the same level, I would say. Look into our application guidelines, what level of English certificate you should have. You should be fluent in, I don't say free of mistakes, of course, but you should be able to read texts in English, to write texts in English, and also to engage in the discussions in English with your fellow students and with your lecturers. The latest projects of the laboratory. I mean, they what they do is they do not just use. I guess you mean the Laboratory for Comparative Social Research. They not just use already available data of the World Value Survey or other big global surveys, but they also produce them. Yeah, so lately they conducted the Russian part for the eighth wave of the World Value Survey, but they also did, for example, a huge comparative survey only in Russia. Yeah, comparative in the sense of they compared the there was a comparative in terms of regional comparison. Yeah, so they conducted in different regions in Russia this big survey. Thematically, this is wide. This goes from from gender questions to corruption to studying general trust to methodological issues. So here there's actually no limitations, and all kinds of issues and topics are studied in the laboratory on the basis of values and attitudes from those big global surveys. And another question here about our teachers, and if there's somebody interested in migrants from Central Asia that come to Russia. Yes, well, this has been studied before. We have invited lecturers doing research on migrants. We have people at the School for Sociology working on migrants. We did have courses. It's hard to say what kind of courses will be available next study year, but there is always some kind of course on migration. We will have this available for our students for sure. There are student lecturers working on migration as well, and of course migrants from Central Asia. This is the biggest migrant group in Moscow and Russia. So you can study this in our program, and we will find a good supervisor for such a project. So for now, we don't have any more questions. I say it again, if you have questions later, please approach me via email. Just write your mail to me. And so this is not here a limitation only to that webinar. I have also, if you are in Moscow, I have consultations every Wednesday at 12 o'clock at Masnitskaya 20 on the ground floor. You can also approach me personally if you like. All right, otherwise there are no more questions. Thank you very much for your attention. Hope to see your applications. Hope you have some good knowledge now about our program. There might be another question I see here. As I said, there are no additional costs for studying in our double degree agreements. Also, if you go abroad via a study exchange, the HSE has quite a lot of partnership agreements for generally. Yeah, so you can go to Berlin or to other universities in Europe or other countries in the world to study. Where you do not, you either get a scholarship via Erasmus Plus, for example, or you don't get a scholarship, but you still do not pay any fees for studying, because it's a partnership agreement. So studying abroad is free of charge. When it comes to studying, of course, you still have to carry your costs of living and transportation. Here's another question about books. This is a good question. I don't know if you know, but our university's general policy and especially also the plans of the rector is to have a book-free, a paper-free education. So a lot of things at HSE are available. Most of the things you have to read, most of the papers and books are available online. We have a library, a normal library at HSE, but the courses in our program, since we use international literature, Russian sources usually, our course programs are built in a way that the literature you need to read is available online via the HSE subscription system. So you don't have to buy any mandatory books. Yeah, so this is not necessary. So you don't have additional costs to buy books. Papers and books are usually online, we use in our courses. Here's a question about how to get one of the free scholarship places in our program. We have, as I showed before, we have 15 places paid by the Russian government, now available until 31st of July. This is only for Russian citizens. The deadline for getting fee waivers for international students is already over. This was in spring. So international students can only apply for fee-based places in our program, but Russians can still apply for fee waivers. There are 15 of those places, but 7 of those are already blocked by winners of our Olympics, which the Olympics took place in spring. So we will have 6 to 7 of those scholarship places available this year. And man, I have to say, we don't receive a lot of applications every year. So the chances to actually enroll in our program are quite good and better than in other programs. It might be has maybe something to do with the English language you need to have on the proper level for our program. But also the academic focus of our program, of course, is attracting those who have ambitions, research-wise. So now already well-educated and have international experience mostly. Yeah? So this is might explain the good chances to actually enroll. Yeah, because this is in the end we have very strong classes with excellent students, so this is a quite ambitious and kind of a demanding classroom also for us teachers, yeah, having to do with such excellent students all the time. Yeah, there seems to be no more questions. Well, thank you again for your attention. Please write emails to me if you have any more questions. Otherwise, have a good evening and bye-bye.